Dr. Arun Kannan, who is a personal close friend of mine professionally and personally. He's done MBBS from MMC, MS from All India Institute, and he has done his fellowship in hip and knee surgery and bone tumors from USA. He's presently a consultant in Apollo Main Hospital, Chennai, and JM Orthocare, Kodambakkam. He's published 15 original research articles in top international orthopedic journals, and especially in hip and knee replacement, revision of failed joint replacements and bone tumor surgery. And he will be talking about an interesting case of windswept deformity of the knees. Over to you, sir.
Hi, Sandeep. Your introduction. Yeah. So I'll make a short presentation of a fairly interesting case that we handled recently. So osteoarthritis is basically a degenerative disease that involves the articular cartilage. Age is the most important risk factor, and it is the most common cause of pain and old age. So as the population of elderly, that is people over 65 years, is rising in India, it is almost doubling every 10 to 15 years. It has gone from about 4 crores in 2001 to about expected to reach about 12 crores in 2026. So, and arthritis of the knee affects almost one-third of adults over 65 years. So we are expecting a huge number of osteoarthritic individuals by 2026. And they are definitely increasing. The other interesting thing is that more than the West, we are seeing OA at an earlier age, just like we see a lot of the metabolic syndromes at an earlier age. We are seeing osteoarthritis fairly commonly in the 50 to 60 year old age group. And osteoarthritis often results in deformity in the severe stages. Deformity is mainly because one compartment is generally affected more than the other. Here, if you can see, this is the left knee. The medial compartment is totally eroded here, while the lateral compartment looks almost intact. The articular cartilage on the lateral compartment is almost intact. So it gives rise to asymmetrical involvement in osteoarthritis, and that is common in most cases of osteoarthritis. The commonest deformity that we see is a varus deformity, or Bolex, as it is commonly known amongst our patients as well, where the medial compartment is severely eroded, but the lateral compartment stays fairly intact. And the less common is the valgus deformity, where the lateral compartment is severely eroded, but the medial compartment is fairly preserved. Like if we look at the ratio, probably 70% of our osteoarthritis cases have a varus deformity, about less than 10% have a valgus deformity, rest of them are somewhat mixed. A very rare presentation is windswept deformity, where there is a varus deformity on one side and a valgus deformity on the other side, as you can see here in this patient. So here on the side of varus deformity, the medial compartment is affected, and on the valgus deformity side, the lateral compartment of the knee is affected. It's a very rare presentation. We come across a case maybe once in a couple of years or one in 3 years. So it's a fairly rare presentation for osteoarthritis. It's more commonly varus on both sides or valgus deformity on both sides. So here, this person has a varus deformity of the right knee, as you can clearly see, and a valgus deformity of the left knee. So this was a patient who presented a few months back. He was a 70-year-old male, diabetic. He had recovered from COVID a couple of months back and had post-COVID mild lung fibrosis, a lot of which was discussed in the previous session as well. And of course, he had severe limitation of walking ability. So I'll just show you how unstable it is when they have this windswept deformity. Varus probably causes the least amount of imbalance, but is quite painful. Valgus is also unstable, but when they have a combined deformity like this, where it is varus on one side and valgus on the other side, they are totally off balance, and the deformity quite rapidly progresses. So for this gentleman, so this is an X-ray or scanogram, as we call it, which is an X-ray showing the entire lower limbs from the hips to the ankles. And you can see that he has severe osteoarthritis on both his knees, medial compartment severely destroyed in the right knee, and the lateral compartment pain. So he is a very appropriate candidate for a knee replacement. And since he is totally off balance, he would ultimately require a bilateral knee replacement. And he's 70 and has post-COVID lung changes, so we considered a staged procedure for him. So, and because of the lung status, and even generally we prefer spinal anesthesia for most of our patients. So for him, we did a right total knee replacement.
Dr. Arun? Dr. Arun?
On the medial side.
Let's wait for Dr. Arun, can you come again? There was a gap in your presentation. I think there is some network issue.
Okay.
Yeah.
From here?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. I was just saying that in view of the severe deformity and the severe disability he had, of course, he is a good candidate for a surgical treatment in the form of knee replacement. Conservative measures are quite unlikely to give much of a response at this stage. And because of his age, we considered a staged procedure, and spinal anesthesia is preferred in general, and for this patient in particular because of the post-COVID lung status. So we did a right TKR followed
his voice is gone again, maybe
in addition to the
video.
Arun, your network is breaking, sir. Again, there is a break at the same spot where you had discontinued, where there was a break last time.
You can save the bandwidth.
Another Wi-Fi network works. Are you able to hear me now, Sandeep?
Not very clear, sir. The voice is breaking.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
No. No, sir.
Just give me a second.
You can quickly log out and log in back again. Sometimes that helps.
Okay, sir.
30 seconds for you, not an issue.
Dr. Arun?
Hello. Sir, Arun is just trying to log in again, sir.
Oh, okay, madam.
Okay, thank you, Sandeep.
Sandeep, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'll just go to my presentation.
Arun, you can switch off your video and do the screen share to save the bandwidth.
Yeah, sure. Hope
that helps.
So, we had planned for a bilateral knee replacement because he was in a severe stage with severe disability. And because of his age and post-COVID lung issue, we staged it by about 3 days. So, we did the right knee followed by the left knee in 3 days. So, this was the X-ray picture at the end of the surgery. The right side, as you can see, is slightly different from the left and required a stem extension because he had a fairly significant bone defect. The left was more regular or simple total knee replacement. So this was him on day 5 after the surgery, and he recovered pretty well for his age at 70. A lot of them require walker assistance for a longer time. But by day 5, he was reasonably getting okay. And at this time, he got discharged and was sent home. And this was at 1 month post-op. He's from his native. He sent the video. Yeah. So, severe deformities are seen in a lot of cases of osteoarthritis. Commonest variety is a varus deformity. Valgus deformity is less common. Windswept deformity, where there is a combination of varus on one side and valgus on the other side, leads to a very unstable gait. But the underlying principles are essentially the same, whether it is varus or valgus. So this was a lady with severe varus. Both pre-op and post-op. So again, varus deformities are also treated the same. Ultimately, the goal is to maintain or get the alignment to neutral and have them good long-term outcome. Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Arun, for the beautiful pre-op and post-op video. It is going to be a life-changing surgery for him, especially with so much instability and pain. I think he will have a good post-operative period. Any questions from the audience? I think that's it, sir. Dr. Arun, that was a very beautiful lecture you have shown.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.